channel. So today's video was actually a very highly requested video. So many people have been in my DM asking me for this video. So as you could tell from the title, today's video is going to be about how often I trim my hair. So many people have been in my DM asking me this question, asking me to make a video on it. So without further ado, let's just get started. And in case you are new to this channel here, you are free to comment whatever video you want to see, whatever your challenges, your worries, whatever questions you have at all. Just make sure to leave them in the comment section down below, and what I do is to pick them one after the other and make a video on them specially for you, because we are here as a family to help each other achieve our goals in our hair journey. Now let's get right back into this video. So like I said, this video is going to be about how often I trim my hair. I know I've mentioned this in one of my videos or in some of my videos, but I have not really gone in detail about it. I have not really answered it in detail, so I just decided to make a detailed video about it. Now, some of us may feel I trim my hair on a regular basis because of the length of my hair, because of the health of my hair, but if you have been watching my videos, I think you already have an idea how often I trim my hair. Okay, the truth is there is no specific time frame I use in trimming my hair. It just depends. For example, when I started my hair journey, I was not trimming my hair at all. Although back then I didn't know about hair care so much. I started researching about hair care tips and how to make your hair healthy, including watching YouTube videos, going online and all that. I started doing that about 3 to 4 years into my hair journey. So in the initial part of my hair journey, I didn't trim my hair at all. And guys, even without trimming my hair, I was still able to get my hair to mid back length. I know some of us may be shocked. If you are new here, you may be shocked, but for those of you that have been watching my videos, I think you know the reason why I was able to do that already. But in case of those that are new here, I was able to grow my hair to mid back length with just protective styling. I was not applying any product on my hair back then. So during that period, I never ever trimmed my hair. Like, I dread trims. Even to this day, I still dread trims, but I have to do it whenever it's necessary, just to make sure I get optimum results in the health of my hair. So like I said, back then I was not getting any trims. I started trimming my hair about 3 to 4 years into my hair journey, and when I started, I was not consistent either, and the trim back then I was getting was actually kind of a rough trim. They were not really in-depth trims. Since I started my hair journey, I've gotten a good trim on my hair just once. Yes guys, just once, and this was last year. I know it's so hard to believe considering the length of my hair and the health of my hair, but that's the truth guys. I've gotten a good trim on my hair just once, and that was last year. And this year I'm going to be getting my second thorough trim, because like I said, the first time I was trimming my hair, I was not really trimming it that much. They were just rough trims, because like I said, I dread trims. Like, the thought of losing inches of hair, and I know how long it takes for you to grow just 1 inch of hair, so the thought of putting all that away was just so scary. But as I progressed in my hair journey, I found out that if I have to retain more length, I have to trim up the damaged parts of my hair. So my method of trimming back then was just to put my hair in a ponytail and just get the tips and chop off about 1 inch. But last year I really went in and got a good trim. I made sure I relaxed my hair, flat ironed my hair to make sure my hair was all stretched out and to make sure I was doing the process right. I am so sorry I was not able to film that video last year, but I'm going to make sure to film my trim this year so that you guys can see the whole process and how I trim my hair. So last year my method of trimming was different. I went into my hair section by section and made sure to get rid of all the damaged parts. I think I cut off about 2 inches of hair last year. I know my hair was really short after cutting it. I was scared that I was not going to be able to grow my hair back, but my hair grew back. In fact, After that trim, my hair grew back with so much speed, faster than the way it was prior to getting the trim. So guys, I don't really have any specific time frame to get my trims. For example, since last year, after that last trim, I have not gotten another trim. So it depends on how my ends feel. If I feel my ends are healthy, I don't bother trimming. But if I look at my ends and they are damaged, they are split, that's when I go in and get a trim. So I only get a trim when it's necessary. There's no specific time frame. It can be just once in a year, it can be once in 6 months, depending on how my ends feel. So this time around, I'm getting another trim because my ends are kind of getting see-through and all that. So that's why I'm going in to get another trim, and I'm going to get that very soon after taking down this protective style and relaxing my hair. And like I said, I'm going to film that video so that you guys see the whole process as well. And I'm really nervous and anxious about that because, like I said, I dread trims, but I don't have a choice. I have to do it because it's necessary for the health of my hair. So I hope I was able to answer you guys' questions. There is no specific time frame I trim my hair. I trim it when I feel it's necessary, when I feel my ends are split, when I feel my ends are damaged. If my ends are healthy, I don't trim at all. And if you've stayed with me to this point of the video, thank you so much. I appreciate your love, I appreciate your support. Thank you all so much. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. And if you are new here and you aren't subscribed already, what are you waiting for? Make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so that you get notified when I upload a video on YouTube. That's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in my next video. Bye.